Hello CSPro users, and welcome to CSPro video tutorial, How Do I Synchronize Data and Applications? CSPro synchronization allows the exchange of files between the device and an FTP server or Dropbox directory. You can send the captured data files from your device to the server and download new versions of data entry applications from the server to your device. In addition, if an internet connection is not available, you can exchange files between two Bluetooth devices. In this video, we describe how to create synchronization specification files, .pnc files, to exchange files between the tablet and Dropbox or FTP servers, create synchronization specification files to exchange files between two tablets via Bluetooth, run a synchronization from logic in a data entry application. CSPro synchronization routines with the file extension .pnc provide the specifications to transfer data and programs back and forth between Android devices and remote machines. You can transfer data via a Dropbox account or by using an FTP server. Multiple synchronization routines can exist on a device, and you will have to determine how you would like to have your interviewer synchronize your data and programs. We begin with simple synchronization from the .pff file. In cases where you would just like to send the data file to the server and download the .pen and .pff files from the server, you can simply use the .pff file for the application to initiate synchronization. Make sure that you have created the .pen file. Place the .pff file and the .pen file into a directory on the FTP server or Dropbox, or you can use a PFF file that is already on your phone or tablet. Then add a new synchronization on the device using that .pff file. From the first screen of CS Entry Android, tap to bring up the menu. Select Synchronize, select Add New. Choose the location, Dropbox, FTP server, or my device, where you have placed the file. And then browse to the location and select it. The synchronization is saved, and CSPro presents a summary of the synchronization. When you run the synchronization will copy the .dat and .not files from your device to a directory on the server, and download the .pen and .pff files to the device from the server. To synchronize, tap to bring up the menu. Tap Synchronize. Select the application to synchronize, and CSPro runs the synchronization. When the synchronization is complete, CSPro issues a message giving the status of the synchronization. The files will be copied to the specified folder. Appending %UID %/%DateTime% to the path prevents the overwriting of files if multiple users use the synchronization. %UID % is a replaceable parameter which will show the user ID. %DateTime % is a replaceable parameter which will show a string containing the date and time. If you select the .pff file from Dropbox or from an FTP server, the data will be copied from the device to the server, and the .pff and .pen files will be copied from the server to the device. If you select the .pff file from the device, data are copied from the device to the server, and the .pff and .pen files are not copied. For more advanced cases, you can use the synchronization specification file, the .pnc file. Using the .pnc file, you can customize the files that get uploaded and downloaded by writing a sync specification file, that is a .pnc file, that lists all transfers of the synchronization. This file contains one or more of the commands shown here. You can also refer to the CSPro helps to view these commands and their descriptions. This is a client-server model where the tablet is the client and the server is either Dropbox or an FTP server. The client issues commands to transfer files and the server responds by receiving or sending files. Get commands copy files from the server to the client and put commands copy from the client to the server. For example, these commands will copy the file pophousecensusdata.dat from the directory csentry/pophousecensus on the device, that is the phone or the tablet, to the directory /pophousecensus/data on the server. When the put is executed, the data file is placed on the server in the /pophousecensus/data folder. In addition to these commands, the .pnc file must also include information about the server being connected to. For Dropbox, it is sufficient to indicate that the connection type is Dropbox. For FTP, you need to add the server URL, username, and password. Complete the .pnc file by adding a section at the beginning showing the version. Here is the completed .pnc file using Dropbox. To add the synchronization to the Synchronize menu on the tablet, use the same method as used to add the synchronization from the PFF file. Follow these 5 steps. Copy the .pnc file to the Dropbox folder, FTP server, or to the phone or tablet via USB connection. Select Synchronize from the drop-down menu. Select Add New. Choose the server where you have placed the file, or choose My Device if it is on the phone or tablet. Then choose the location of the .pnc file. CSPro connects to the server and finds the .pnc file. The synchronization is now in the Synchronize menu. Once the synchronization is added to the Synchronize menu, the .pnc file is no longer needed. It is copied to a hidden directory on the tablet that is secured to prevent the discovery of passwords. Any changes to the original .pnc file will have no effect on the synchronization. To modify an existing synchronization, you need to repeat the process of adding it in order to replace the existing version. In the first section of the file, we can also add a description. Description equals, for example, synchronize pophousecensus data. This description will be displayed on the screen while performing synchronization. This will be illustrated in the upcoming example. In this example, we will synchronize the mycappy_intro application with Dropbox. We will send the data file, mycappy_data.dat, to the server, and download the mycappy_intro.pff and mycappy_intro.pen files from the server to the tablet. All of the files for the application are in the csentry/mycappy_intro folder, so we will use that as client path. CSEntry is the default folder for CSPro applications on the device. The specified folders exist within the CSEntry folder. We will place the .pen and .pef files in the sync mycappy_intro/app folder in Dropbox. So that will be the server path for get. We will place the data files in the folder syncmycappy_intro/data. So that will be the server path for put. Here we show the complete .pnc file based on these specifications. If multiple users use this synchronization, the second synchronization will replace the first sent. To avoid this problem, specify different directories on the server for each user. %date%, %date time%, %UID%, or %device ID% can be included in the directory name. %date% is replaced by the date. %date time% is replaced by the date and time. %UID% is replaced by the name of the tablet user. This comes from the email used to configure the tablet. %device ID% is replaced by the system-generated unique ID of the device. For example, if the username is Tailo, and we change the server path in our .pnc file as follows. Server path equals /syncmycappy_intro/data/%UID/. The file will be placed in the folder /syncmycappy_intro/data/Tailo/. It may be that this folder does not exist, in which case you will get an error when your synchronization tries to copy a file to it. To avoid this, add the command create server path to create the folder, as shown here. If you ever have problems with synchronization, you can view the synclog.txt file in the CSEntry directory. This file contains a detailed log of all files transferred and all errors encountered during synchronization. Using synchronization, you can exchange files between phones and tablets using Bluetooth even without an internet connection. In this scenario, one device takes the role of server and the other is the client. Only the client issues get, put, client path, and server path commands. On the client device, the only difference in the .pnc file for Bluetooth synchronization is the type of connection, which is Bluetooth, and the addition of the server device name indicating the name of the other tablet or phone that is acting as the server. The server tablet will also have a .pnc file with a connection type of Bluetooth server and without any get or put commands. This is because all commands are initiated only on the client. The root folder line specifies the path on the tablet from which files are shared. That is, the path specified by the set server path command is concatenated with the root folder to establish the full path on the server. For example, we want to use Bluetooth to copy data from the enumerator's tablet to the supervisor's tablet. On the enumerator's tablet, we have a data file, pophousecensusdata.dat, in the csentry/pophousecensus folder. On the supervisor's tablet, we would like to place this file in the folder csentry/pophousecensus/receipt_from_enumerator/%UID%. Here we show the commands for the client or the enumerator's tablet. Note that the server device name is the device name of the Android device. You can get this name by navigating to the Android device home screen, tapping on Settings, Bluetooth, choosing Rename this device or Edit device name from the menu. Here we show the PNC file for the server, which is the supervisor's tablet. Now that we have seen how the synchronization works, let's apply the synchronization to the MyCopy Intro application. The left side of the screen will show what's happening with the client or the enumerator side, and the right side of the screen will show what's happening with the server or the supervisor's tablet. First, we write the PNC files. These files can be created with Notepad or any other text editor. Once the PNC files are created, copy them to the respective devices. To add the synchronization, select Synchronize from the menu, select Add New, select My Device, select the .pnc file for the enumerator or the supervisor, and the synchronization is created. CSPro will then display a summary of the synchronization. Now that the synchronization is created, follow these steps to synchronize. Select Synchronize from the menu. Select the application to synchronize. The name is from the .pnc file. If this message appears, select Allow to allow this tablet or phone to be discovered by other Bluetooth devices. The Bluetooth devices connect and are synchronized based on the specifications in the .pnc file. A successful completion message is issued once the synchronization is complete. To make changes to the .pnc file, make the changes for the .pnc file on your Windows machine using any text editor such as Notepad. Copy the .pnc file to the device. From the Synchronize menu, select Add New. Select the location of the .pnc file, Dropbox, FTP server, or My Device. Then navigate to and select the .pnc file. If the synchronization does not exist, CSPro creates a new synchronization. If the synchronization already exists, CSPro will overwrite the old synchronization with the new synchronization. You can launch synchronizations in CSPro Logic using the sync function, which takes the name of the synchronization file as the argument. If file name is a full path, the synchronization will look for the file in the specified path. Otherwise, it looks for the .pnc file in the same directory as the .pen file. And if it does not find it there, it searches for it among the .pnc files that are installed in the synchronization menu. The function sync has an optional second argument, Q, that will wait to start the synchronization after data entry is complete. This can be useful because during data entry, the questionnaire being entered is not yet saved. Q tells the sync function to synchronize after the questionnaire has been saved. This brings us to the end of our video tutorial on synchronization in CSPro. Please explore our many other tutorials on the many aspects of CSPro.